Hi guys, and welcome to today's video. My name is Stephanie, this is Kyle, and we are going to talk about our upcoming wedding. We're getting married at Walt Disney World in March, which is a month away, which is crazy. And we're just gonna talk about our Disney fairy tale wedding experience and questions that we've gotten that we feel like we should answer in a video and that kind of stuff. This will especially be helpful if you did not watch the ThruTheEars stories on our Instagram. By the way, ThruTheEars is my family's Disney like podcast, YouTube channel, blog, all that kind of stuff. We do everything. We just talk about Disney a lot. So, this is Kyle. Kyle's been to Disney four times?
I lost count.
Four or five times?
Yeah, more than that.
So, he started going to Disney once we started dating. I've always been a Disney-obsessed gal. We never really thought that we would get married at Disney. That was never, like, my dream, I guess. But because of, like, COVID and everything, then we figured we wanted a small wedding because we weren't really sure, like, what was going to happen. Anyway, long story short, we decided to do a Disney wedding. It's not going to be a huge, like, 1,000 people there. It's going to be very small. We have, like, 50 people there. But we just want to dive right into what entails a Disney wedding.
What to expect.
What to expect.
What not to expect.
That's true. And we're going to be very straightforward with you guys. I do not sugarcoat things. I'm completely honest. And I hold Disney to extremely high standards, not only because I've had very good experiences at Disney from growing up there, but because I work there too, so I know what kind of training and everything all the cast members have been through. So I just hold them to a higher standard. They've set the expectation.
Yeah, they do all this stuff for the parks and try to make a magical experience for everyone.
A couple things about the whole wedding process. We started planning the wedding about 10 months ago is when we kind of started. That was when we figured, we had looked at like prices and stuff, and then we realized that Disney actually would be a good option for us. And that's when we actually started like planning stuff and like emailing them and kind of like getting our foot in the door with the whole wedding process. And then they sent us over a pamphlet, which they would do to anybody, even if you're just inquiring about it. That goes kind of over the details and like ceremony options and like where you can have the wedding, where you can have receptions, that kind of stuff. Just kind of like a basic layout and then kind of like price sheet, you know, a roundabout kind of thing. So we looked at that and we both really like the Polynesian. That's my personal favorite resort. We also just like the theming of it and stuff and just kind of the views and everything. Plus I did want an outside wedding. So I was one of the best resorts to have that at. So anyway, we decided on the Polynesian and we're getting married at Luau Point, which is kind of like a garden setting, I would say, because he doesn't really like the beach very much, so he didn't want it to be like near the sand, which I kind of agree with. I wouldn't want it.
Sand gets everywhere that you don't want it.
Yeah. Okay. So we decided on that, which was kind of like it was on the lower end as far as price goes. We decided on that, and then you kind of email Disney back and forth and they kind of give you different options. Now, the hardest part, at least recently, at least from what we've experienced, is when dealing with the Disney Fairy Tale Wedding team, everything is just emailing back and forth, and then you set up times to do like interviews and Zoom interviews and stuff like that, just like Zoom calls. And that makes it extremely difficult to plan anything, to ask questions, to get feedback, anything like that, because it's very hard. You know, I might have a question, I'll send that to them and I'll get a response 2, 3, 4 weeks later.
If they even get the email.
If they even get the email. That's another issue too. Sometimes I've sent emails multiple times and then they've just never gotten back to me or said that, oh, sorry, like we didn't see that, or, you know, kind of stuff like that. So that's been very difficult. Even we've been to Disney 3 or 4 times since we've started planning the wedding, and never have we been able to talk to anybody in person. So that has been extremely difficult. I personally, I just hate emailing in general. It's just not my thing.
We're old fashioned. We like face to face.
Yeah. So even just small questions that you have, you have to wait a very long time to get a response. So your best bet is to, if this is a scenario for you, make a list of all the questions that you have and send that all in one email. So that way there's more of a likelihood that they will actually answer all of those emails from that, or all of those questions from that.
Or wait until the video chats come up and then make sure you get all the answers exactly through there.
Yeah, if you if you're lucky enough to actually see them on Zoom, like, ask all your questions.
We've had a couple instances where we've had the Zoom meetings and we ask a question and then they have to get back to us.
Mm-hmm.
That usually takes a little bit.
Yeah.
The only ones that's been pretty quick is actually the floral team itself.
Yeah, the florists were amazing. They answered all of our questions. And then I ended up having to change the color of like the bridesmaid dresses just because the other one wouldn't be ready in time and stuff like that. And she was like super quick, literally emailed me that day. And she was like, oh yeah, you know, the colors can be the same. Like everything looks good for that. Like she was just really good. And so that was amazing. But there are different like teams and departments that you will talk to. So as far as like, you know, food prep kind of stuff, the florist, like everything has its own person that you will talk to. And then there's one direct, you know, main point of contact, I guess, for like general wedding questions. That has been where I've had the most difficulty communicating with the whole Disney team and stuff like that. As far as like food goes, we were looking at potentially doing a dinner because we're getting married at 2:30 at the Polynesian. And so obviously we can't have lunch because that's like after, in the middle of lunch or after lunch. So we were looking at doing dinners. So you have to book it. There's certain like venue options that they will give you. It's not like you can go to like Ohana's and eat there. And we were looking at prices and it is extremely expensive. And then there's just a bunch of like tiers onto that. And then plus the food itself, it's just, there's a lot. So we opted not to do that because that was going to like triple the price of the wedding. And we decided to do a fireworks show at Epcot, which ended up being a much better price point. Plus you can pick your food that you have there and they do it like a buffet style, which is really nice. So people can physically like to pick what they're having that day. Which I thought that was cool. So we're doing a pasta station. So they'll have like Alfredo and marinara and they'll have chicken, they'll have meatballs, all that good stuff laid out. And then we're doing an ice cream bar so people can pick their ice creams. And then I think we're gonna have Mickey Mouse Rice Krispie Treats and then we'll obviously have our wedding cake. Why are you laughing?
Because you and your Mickey Mouse
Rice Krispie Treats? Rice
Krispie Treat things.
Okay, I worked at the confectionery and during my college program and I became very obsessed with Mickey Mouse Rice Krispie Treats and so they needed to be at the wedding. They needed to make an appearance. So anyway, that is what we're doing as far as that goes, and price point wise it ended up being much cheaper and we get a show with it, so it's like a win-win-win. At least in my book, we haven't experienced it yet, so
the one thing that we had a problem, one of the trips that we went out there when we were planning the whole wedding, we went in to check out the area that they allow this in.
Mm-hmm.
And what show's there at Epcot right now?
Harmonious.
Harmonious. So Harmonious, if you haven't seen it yet, it's pretty much more of an electronic area, but we have the side view. Mm. So we don't get to see the full experience of the show.
That's true.
We get to see fireworks, pretty much.
Yes, yeah. So the area that we are like having the dinner show is in the UK pavilion and it's like right behind where the Rose and Crown restaurant is. So it's like the little platform area, but it is, yeah, you definitely get a side view. So the projections and stuff and like the things that are moving. Yeah.
The water projections.
Yeah. Yeah, that we're going to have a very awkward view of it. I think it's hard to tell. Like they don't really actually, I don't even know if the place that we're looking at is actually the right place. That's another thing as far as like the whole wedding process goes, because everything's virtual right now.
You have to guess.
You kind of have to guess. So as far as the fireworks show goes, if you know, end up doing that option, the fireworks show, we get there. See, that's the other thing. We don't even know any of this kind of stuff. Like, we haven't been told what time people get there. Like, it's just,
so right now, from what we're seeing and kind of being told, is during that time, all our guests have to meet in front of Epcot, if they don't have a ticket, of course.
So there were a couple options. You can pay like $700 or $800, and then there's going to be a bus that goes and picks up the guests and drops them all off at a central location. Or there's the option of all your guests can meet in one place, and then you walk over to the where the fireworks show is happening. We opted not to do the one where it's picking up guests because some of our guests aren't at Disney for a very long amount of time. A lot of our guests aren't there for a long time, so they're kind of like packing a trip into our wedding. And so in case they wanted to be at the parks, we didn't want it to have to cut into their day. We kind of wanted it to be able to, all they have to do is like get themselves there at that time, but they can be anywhere else before that. They don't have to be at the resort, anything like that.
And some of our guests aren't even staying on property.
Yeah, and some of the guests aren't staying on property. Some of them don't even know if they can come yet until kind of like school schedules come out and everything like that. So that's another thing too that you can opt to do or not to do. Disney will give you options as far as music goes. So they'll give you a list of music that you can have when walking up to the wedding.
It and then does come with a violinist, I believe.
Yeah,
so
you can
the
pick,
price does include that.
Yeah, you can pick a violinist, a guitarist. I think those are the two options. And then the other ones you'd have to pay for if you want something separate. But that comes with the actual ceremony itself. And then you can either pick your own officiant, or Disney has ones that they could provide for you. Same thing with photography. If you want somebody to come from like the outside that you know, you can do that, or Disney has their own options. We chose to go with somebody from Disney just to make it a little bit easier. Plus, I wasn't really familiar with any photographers in that area. So that's what we decided. And so that's all kind of good. That was relatively easy to go through and pick because it was kind of laid out for us. And then we just had to pick like the little details.
It has like two or three different types of timing that you pay for. So you pay for either 2 hours, 4 hours, or like 6 hours or something like that.
For what?
For the photography.
Yes. Yeah. So he'll be there for the fireworks show too, which is exciting.
Okay.
Another thing we should probably go over is like guest benefits, I guess. So if you're planning a Disney wedding, you do get discounted tickets and discounted rooms for all your guests. And Disney, like once you actually start planning your wedding, Disney will send you that link, and then you can send that link to all your guests, and that's how they go through and do like the room block and stuff like that. As far as on our part goes, we have to pick, like we picked three different resorts that our guests could choose from. So what happens then is we pick whatever resorts that we want, and then Disney will have a room block for them. So they'll pretty much just put those resorts on hold. We just have to choose how many of those rooms we choose to hold, like how many people we think are going to be there and stuff like that. Now you give them an estimate, and you just can't go too much below that estimate. Otherwise Disney will charge you because it does.
It's holding the room.
Yeah, you're literally having to hold the rooms. So I would say, honestly, try to be as accurate as possible just because you don't want to end up having to pay too much, but you also want enough to where you know your guests are going to be able to have availability.
And the hard part is also trying to do this, pretty far in advance, just because that's when you get the best room rates and availability. Like right now, one of my uncles and aunts had a hard time getting a room because they waited to the last minute. And everything filled up.
Yeah, by that time the room block stuff had already been taken, and so that was difficult for them to be able to find something. Another thing is, as far as that like whole thing goes, we booked that like room block about 7 months ago. So
I'd say 8 months, yeah.
Yeah, 7 or 8 months ago. It was pretty far in advance. We were lucky because we happened to be pretty accurate, but we also knew a lot of the people that were coming for sure. That's who we planned on to do the room block for, if that makes sense.
Yeah, another thing is it makes it easier if you have a smaller wedding.
Yeah, that's true too. So I would suggest make it kind of like immediate family, friends, like that's it. Another thing, as far as that goes, so tickets are discounted. I honestly don't know how much they're discounted.
I'm not sure. I know they got discounted tickets but you have to call.
Yeah.
And then they let you know through there.
Yeah, so that's all set and everything. I think you can do park hoppers or regular single day, kind of whatever you choose to do. The cool thing was, if we got more than 10 rooms booked, then we get a free night at Disney.
At one of our select three.
Yeah, one of the three that you choose. So we got ours at the Polynesian. So woohoo, we get a free night because we got more than 10 rooms booked.
More than 10 rooms, and then it jumps up to 50, which is big jump, but sometimes it's probably easier if you do have that bigger wedding to fill that up. I think we had like
47.
So we were pretty close.
Yeah, if you get up to 50 rooms booked, then you get 2 free nights.
Correct.
We were so close, but it's okay. I was trying to get a reservation for his family and my family to be able to all eat together, wanting to do it the night before, to where we could all eat together and just, you know, whatever. But you can't book any reservations through them for any Disney restaurants, if that makes sense. And so then they suggested that we call the Disney Dining. So we tried calling them. You can't book it unless it's 60 days out, just like you would as a normal guest.
We also got referred to, I believe, the what's called the group dining, if I'm correct on that.
Yes.
And that's not even a thing right now.
Yeah, so they're not doing that right now either because of COVID, or it has to be 60 days out, that kind of stuff. So anyway, we waited till we were exactly 60 days out, gave them a call, and they were like, oh, sorry, like, we don't do that. You would have to contact Disney Weddings directly for that. But they were the ones that told us to contact them, so it was just a whole thing. So I ended up just getting different family members' Disney logins and had them each reserve a reservation for the same restaurant at around the same time. So that was the closest I could get to us, like, eating together. So the day before, we're going to Kona Cafe, and we're all eating around the same time between 9:15 and like 9:40 or something. I just wanted us to be able to kind of eat together, just because this is such a rare thing to actually happen that, I don't know, it just kind of seemed good. But yeah, it's just been very, if I'm being completely honest, the whole entire thing has been very unorganized. If you are listening to this and you're trying to decide, like, if a Disney wedding would be good for you or not, I would say, you know, if you're a Disney fan like I am, if you love Disney so much, I would say go for it if your goal is to just have time with your family, to be able to, you know, be thankful, be with them, have fun with them, go to the parks with them, that kind of stuff. I wouldn't do it because you want a fairy tale wedding, because it doesn't seem like that's, like, necessarily priority. Luckily for us, we really just care about being there with our family and having fun.
We're using this whole experience, to be honest, to be able to, one, get her whole family over to Disney, which hasn't happened since they were younger.
Mm-hmm.
And then my family, we're a military family. My brother's in the military as well. So we don't take vacations as much anymore.
Mm-hmm.
To be able to get him, my nephews, my parents, and just everyone in one area for at least a couple days to spend time and to celebrate a special moment in our lives.
Yeah, exactly. So it's hard to tell because that also hasn't happened yet. It could be the most organized thing ever once we get there, and it could be, you know, super magical, crazy, like, all that kind of stuff. But this experience so far has been stressful
and a little frustrating.
And frustrating because it takes so long to get answers, and they're just not very helpful. They don't seem very happy to help you. And it's just, yeah, it's just not what I expected, I guess. But we're still very excited to have this wedding. We're thankful to even be able to have the opportunity to do this in general. And so we're definitely not taking this for granted.
We're still excited, and we're looking forward to it, because at the end of the day, it's the whole point of us is to join together.
Yeah, exactly. But if you're you know, part of the Disney wedding team, if you're watching this, you know, maybe just, like, sit back and, like, put yourself in a perspective of somebody that's never, ever done a wedding before, and, you know, just kind of on the same wavelength. Yeah. I think if it was in person, that would be
a different experience.
Yeah.
Stay tuned. We'll definitely let you know after the wedding, the overall
experience. And I'll video the wedding, too. I'll vlog it. So I'm very excited for that. But we, like I said, we're extremely thankful. No matter what, if Disney stresses us out, if it's, you know, if we don't feel like they're organized, we're going to make the best day out of it, and we're going to have a good time no matter what. So, whatever.
Yeah. And then she's stuck with me.
Yeah. You're stuck with me. That's the harder part.
That's a little crazy.
Yeah. So I hope this answered any of your questions. I know this is kind of all over the place, but I figured we should make a video now before we get married, and then maybe make one afterwards and kind of, like, see where, you know, maybe we're just crazy right now. Maybe
it's all
gonna be perfectly organized. Who knows? But that's where we are now. If you have any questions about the wedding, leave it down below. Otherwise, thank you for watching this video. I hope you'll have a great and magical day. And is that it?
Okay.